because that's what we work towards. You know, when I took the job, I said, I don't want to be in this job for 10 years, and then I'm only disputing my first cup final, and that's why I'm doing the job. Fortunately, the second season, and twice we're in the final. So, yeah, I want to win it for the players. I think, you know, they deserve it. They put in all the hard work, they put in the effort, and then they deserve to be two finals. Unfortunately, the last time, but I think this time, you know, we don't want to become that team that gets to finals, but and then we can't get over the line. So, yeah, we want to put all our efforts and our energy into this one. It's not going to be easy because I think Super Sports has found their range now. And last game, we came out with 4-0 team, so it's not going to be the easiest game for us, but we don't care who they played against or what they've done. Come Saturday, it's going to be a completely different game. You know, two teams that's playing to win it, but I hope my boys will be as hungry as ever, you know, to make it second time count.
What's the vibe being in the camp line?
No, actually, the atmosphere has been really good. Better than I expected. I expected us to be a little bit more, a bit uptight, and starting to get the nerves, the butterflies kicking in now, and the final jitters. But no, the boys have been, they've been calm, and we've just been training and working on things where we should improve, where we can improve, and then obviously work on the basis of the good second half comeback that we had against Pirates. So we just try and try and get everyone back fit and everyone on song, because I want to have the best team to select. I want to have from the best players to pick. I don't want to have headaches, who to leave out and who not to leave out. But I don't want it to be made easy for me with a few players out injured. You know, so hopefully we can get to that road where we have all our good top players, the ones that can win us games or that can go out there and compete. We want to have them all fit so I can have a nice pot to select from.
Coach, you must have been frustrated by the slow starts against what sort of, I mean, how do you motivate them to get going from the first whistle?
I think it's just to change our approach a little bit, you know, because we've always allowed ourselves to settle in the game before we go, and I think maybe using that expression meant that the players take their time to get into a game instead of from the off when we go in there and we make our presence felt, and attack teams from the first minute to the last minute, you know? So maybe changing, saying the right words, saying the right things, you know? So that's the only way we can change it, because we want to get ourselves into the game first, you know? We don't want to get behind it, I think, because when you say that, maybe the players think that it's for us to sit back and soak up the pressure, and then after 15, 20 minutes, once we're in the game, and then we can go, and then that by then the opposition is already out of range, or look like they're out of range, and then from minute 20, that's when we settle it down. But I think if we say that we start out fresh and we go from the first minute and we go with them and make sure we don't make early silly mistakes, and that's maybe that can help. So we'll change our approach the way we go at this game to other games and getting ourselves to settle down.
You word on the run, are you hoping that he can make the bench?
Yeah, of course, we're always hopeful. So he's working mainly with the physical coach and with the physio, with Mark. So he had a little setback. Obviously, we pushed him really hard, you know, because we want him to get back into the shape, into the levels where we know that he can hurt can hurt teams in this league, and he's one of the best strikers that's out there in the country. You know, and one of them is best. So yeah, and I think us pushing him a little bit, so now I had a couple of setbacks, so his hamstring a little bit tight. So now we don't wanna push, we just reduce this workload and see how he responds. If he can, if we get the okay by tomorrow and then hopefully Thursday we can go into Thursday with the possibility that he might be there. Not saying that he's gonna be there, but there might be a possibility that we, you know, if all systems go, then we might be able to have him available for a camera. Surprises. Touch and go. He's also together with Ranko, training apart from the team. And those two are the only two that has injury worries, that you know that we wait until Thursday to see if will happen available.
It's been easier to do.
Funeral, Ranko.
Personally, last time you went to the brilliant, like a month and a half after coach. How's this one? How are you approaching this one?
Worse. Because the first one I was only a month into coaching. So I had no chances of getting fired if I lose. You know? Now I'm steady, I have stability, and obviously, so now is any chance that the chairman might aim a shotgun at me, you know, if we don't get over the line with this one. Because I think I was fearless there, you know, because obviously I've never been in that situation. Now that I am, I've been in that situation and I'm a year in the job, I'm a bit more cautious and I'm a bit more wary of anything. Things can go wrong, things don't go wrong. Then I was assured that we had a good enough team to go and win it, and I was confident that we would win it. You know, I didn't bag on that we'll be suck at penalties. But anyway, so I've grown, and I've learned, and I've improved, and my team's also grown very much, very, very mature, and I think we're in a better situation than ever.
Especially in penalty taking after the Sundowns.
Ah, don't be fooled by one penalty. I think, we've got a good crop. We've got specialists now in the team, you know, specialized in penalty taking. So the team, the depth is far more better than what it was last season.
You smashed SuperSport 2-0 at the start of the season, but like you said, they kind of finding their feet. How have you prepped and what do you expect from them?
Obviously, we've been watching a lot of their games, you know, watch the Black Leopards game, but I think that's a smokescreen game. I don't want to be taking much from there. The fact that they team that scores goals, a lot of goals. So I think we've mainly just focused on the games we've played against them. I think it's probably the best definition that we can take from all this. If we want to learn how to play, we've played them four times. Five times up to now. Final, twice in the league last season, and once or four times. We've played them four times. And if you analyze the four games, it's more or less the same personnel for them that's featured in all four games that they've played against us. You know, 90% of their team hasn't changed against us. There's maybe two or three new players, Basera, who's came in that I've never played against, but he played against us the opening game. Mukwena, he hasn't played the last game, which he might play, but your Pongani Kumalo also hasn't played against us yet, but it's been always Morgan Gould and Clayton Daniels for the big Nigerian
Yeah, he's gone now.
Yeah. Oh, it was that one.
Good.
Yeah, but so the personnel has always stayed the same. And Ruzicki has came in, but he's played against us twice now for them. So I think the best way is for us to analyze them is to watch the games that we've played where we've done exceptionally well and the same patterns that they have and where we've struggled. So we go down and we have a look and then we just go and we work on our weaknesses where we've not done so well against them, where they could have hurt us in some instance in the games that they've played against us. So then we've looked at our weaknesses against them in those four games, and then that's what we try and rectify and perfect here in the training, so that come that game, it's a game for minimum mistakes. You know, the team that makes the least mistakes at that place with the biggest heart, that's the team that's going to come out on top. Not necessarily the team that gets it technically spot on, because yeah, in a final, cup final, tactics is important, but it doesn't determine, you know, it determines courage and heart and effort and hard work. The team that goes out there fighting and lays it all down on the pitch, that's the team that's most likely going to walk away with the spoils.